road rage over privatized parking. City leaders are expected to get an earful from concerned drivers during the first public hearing on the $92 million plan tonight. WLWT News 5's John London joining us live from City Hall, where this meeting is going to begin in less than 30 minutes. John, this deal may go through despite what anyone says tonight, though, right?
Well, it might, Cherie. The plan appears to have 4 votes. It needs 5. And this week's public input will be part of what council members Young and Seelbach, those are the two on the fence, take into consideration. Defenders of the deal, like the city manager Milton Dehoney, emphasizes it modernizes the parking system, retains public oversight of rates, and brings in upfront money for investment and job growth. Critics say that's so much sugar sprinkled on molded bread, they see it as onerous for neighborhood businesses and bountiful for an out-of-state firm that will run roughshod over the city system for 30 years. Tonight, the manager says if the deal goes bust, he goes into cut mode, and that means layoffs.
Cut mode does not get you a growing economy. We will never be able to get to where we need to and address the structurally imbalanced budget simply by cutting. You just can't get there using that methodology. You can shorten your expense side, but that will still creep up over time.
City manager Milton Dehoney saying that rating agencies tell him the city needs to get more revenue and that this plan, although no panacea, is part of an aggressive push to growth and as a growth now as opposed to 10 years from now. Reporting live at City Hall, John London, WLWT News 5.
All right, and we should mention also that the city's garages are included in this parking plan, although officials have not released any information about how rates and enforcement would change for those lots if this deal is approved.